What's up, everybody? This week's video, I want to talk about pegging your weight. You'll hear a lot of people say that, yes, they always peg their weights. And some people say, no, I never peg my weights. I'm somewhere in the middle. So I have two examples here for you where I always peg a weight. And then I have two examples where I do not peg a weight for you. But first, for anybody that doesn't know what I'm talking about, pegging a weight refers to putting a bobber stop in front of your bullet weight so that you restrict the weight from moving up and down the line. Okay, so two examples of where I always peg a weight: pitching, flipping, or casting a creature bait or a craw style bait. The reason that is those style baits, when you cast them out and they hit the bottom, I want them to stay on the bottom and not free float at all. So you cast it out, it hits the water, it's going to sink to the bottom. As you raise your rod tip and lift that bait up, once you let your rod tip down, this bait's going to sink right to the bottom again. This is going to trigger a strike of something that's sitting directly on the bottom, similar to a crawfish, how they crawl along the bottom, or just a general forage that might be bumping along the bottom, okay? Now, times when I do not peg my bullet weight are with ribbon tail worm applications and with using weighted Senkos. So the reason behind that is when you don't peg the weight on a worm, you're gonna cast this bait out, and as it hits the water, the weight is going to fall and it'll hit the bottom. This worm is going to free float down very slowly. As you raise your rod tip, you're going to force that weight back to the tip of the worm. And as you pull up, the action in the tail of the worm is going to be on the lift. As you lower your rod tip, you're also lowering that weight and allowing that worm to free fall. What this does is this worm has a lot of action in the water as you lift it up, and it gets their attention. As that weight hits the bottom and the worm just starts floating slowly, it's going to stay in that strike zone a little bit longer, and usually they will pick it up when it's just sitting there or floating very, very slowly. I will also use it without pegging it with a Senko. Senkos get a lot of their action from floating in the water, just sinking. So you can imagine, as you lift your rod tip, the weight goes down to the bottom. This Senko is just going to be fluttering down and doing exactly what it would do if you were using it weightless. You just have the benefit of a weight that you can get it down to the bottom. So peg, don't peg. Again, I always peg when I'm using a creature style bait or a craw style bait. I almost never peg when I'm using a ribbon tail worm of some kind like this, or a Senko. So hopefully you guys got something out of that. If you have reasons other than what I mentioned that you peg your weights or don't peg your weights, always leave a comment below. As always too, give that video a like and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, wherever you are, whatever you do, love the cast.